Building a hull can be a challenge, so I'll share the way I design ships hull to help you get started. First, I like to place a line of blocks to set the width of the ship. It's not too hard to make the width wider or narrower later on, so just get it somewhere close. Turn on X symmetry and drag a line of blocks out to the side. For this example, I've placed 10 blocks, and with symmetry and the starting block, the width is 21 blocks or 5.25 meters. Now I'll shape the bow, which is the front of the ship. Starting with 1x4 wedges, place them at the very edge and drag them forwards. If you drag them all the way, you will have a very pointy bow, and if you only place one or two, you could end up with a round or flat bow. For this width, 3 1x4 wedges looks good. Change to the 1x2 wedges and attach them to the ends of the 1x4 wedges. Often there will be more 1x2 wedges, but for this scale of hull, 3 1x2 wedges is looking best. Then we repeat with the 1x1 wedges, drag them out until you have a 1 block gap, although sometimes a 3 block gap might be better. Then you can place a 1x1 block to finish it off. This is where you should decide how tall your ship will be and what kind of angle you want the bow to have. Keep in mind Stormworks character models are 7 blocks high, so an 8 or 9 block floor height is typical. I'll be creating a single floor inside the hull, so to do this, select the 4x4 pyramids and start pulling them down and backwards from the first 1x4 wedge you place. Since two of these blocks is 8 high, you can count every two 4x4 pyramids as a single floor space. Delete the top 4x4 pyramid so you can place a new one and drag along the length of the 1x4 wedges. Overdo it a bit so the inverse pyramid gets placed, and then delete the overhanging 4x4 pyramid. Until you are building the very tip of the bow, you want to have a straight vertical ends to all the pyramids on the hull. Now swap over to the 4x4 inverse pyramid, and look through to the other side of the hull so you can place these internally. Drag it out so that it fills the bottom row with pyramids. I do this part looking through the hull because it's easier to get the whole row placed. Now swap over to the 2x4 pyramids and drag the first row along, again overdoing it and deleting the last pyramid, so we end up with the inverse pyramid at the tip. We can place the bottom row of 2x4 pyramids without having to use the opposite side because we now have a row to start off. Drag the second row of 2x4 pyramids out, and if you drag your mouse up to the tip of your bow, it will pull the wedges out all the way and you can delete the pyramids you don't want. Now it's time to decide the angle of the bow. I want to use a 1x2 angle, so rotate around under so you can see the bottom or the very tip of the bow. Select the 1x2 wedge and drag it down. Change to the 1x2 pyramids and fill in the top row. You'll see it doesn't quite line up, but that's okay. It lets us know where to cut and replace. Delete the 2x4 inverse pyramids that are touching the 1x2 pyramids, following the diagonal edge down. If we change to the 1x2 inverse pyramid now and place them along the edge we just deleted, everything starts to line up. And then we can fill in the remaining space with 1x2 pyramids. Move the camera so that you can see the bottom of the hull. Ships with a wide and flat hull will be more stable in Stormworks. So we want to round this hull out very slightly at the bottom. And to carry on the 1x2 angle at the tip of the bow, I will use the 1x2 wedges and pyramids. Start by dragging the 1x2 pyramid off the tip of the bow and stop before it becomes a 2x4 pyramid. Then change to the 2x2 pyramid and drag it to meet the 1x2 pyramids. Move the camera to the back of the bow and place a 2x4 pyramid rotated 90 degrees compared to the pyramids already in the bow, and drag them towards the front all the way. Change to the 1x1 block and drag along the very bottom to create the floor of the hull. Change to the 1x2 wedge, place it on the 2x4 wedges at the bottom and drag them backwards, and fill in the floor again. Move the camera up to the top and we'll clean up and fill in the main deck of the hull. Delete any internal wedges and then place a layer of 1x1 blocks across the top to make the main deck. Now you can place the walls using 1x1 blocks and increase the length of the main deck with 1x1 blocks. This method works for me every time regardless of what shape hull I'm making, and the resulting hull is fairly stable on its own. Adding weight to the center at the bottom and roll stabilizers is sometimes necessary, but by starting with a wide and flat hull, you won't need as much stabilization later. Here are some examples of pointed bows and very round bows. The good thing is they all use the same building methodology. Thanks for watching. Leave us a like, and I'll see you next time.